Keynote is a must-have presentation tool for every good presenter. Now let me run you through on how simple the usage for Keynote is. I use my Keynote to extensively create presentations on my iPad, and let me show you why I love this. Let's say we go in with the heading here. So I don't use an external keyboard because I find the keyboard with the iPad itself is easier. And this is how easy it gets in terms of changing the fonts or colors. Here you go, as you can see. Yep, that's done. By Andy. And what I like about Keynote is how easy it's that you can create a template and not just go on with existing templates that's out there. So, you know, for me, I play with colors and with different shapes a lot. So let's say, for example, need to change the shade of this. It goes here. Yep, this one. And this is how I normally create what do you call that, templates, rather than sticking on with whatever is there. In fact, every time I do a presentation, I ensure that I create a template from scratch. Right, so as you can see, okay, let me take that back. All right, we have that. Well, probably if you want to add a logo, let's see, this is the logo. If we want to increase the opacity a bit or decrease, okay, oh, it's done. Oh yeah, that's a kick-ass. Now, for me to create template, all I do is group, copy it, and I just add it onto every slide. See? Simple. And let's say the master slide. Again, copy, group, and here you go. I rotate it a bit. Oh, voila. Oh, you have your custom template. Yeah. And let's go on with the further details. Now, objective. Let's reduce the size a bit. Okay, that's good. Oops, the spelling. To create a deck. If you want to change custom colors, select. Change the colors directly from here. Voila. Nice. Can add text easily, just text, blah blah blah. Gonna change the fonts a bit probably. Alright, here you go. If you want to add some sort of icons, let's say yep, reduce the size easily. Make it, yep. If you want to, you know, again, look at the opacity. That's it. That's how simple it is, but I still feel something is missing. So let's say I make it further small. What do you think? Huh? It's also easy to add images and so for example, let's say I have a lot of stock images always traded up for this purpose. That shade needs to go, so I'm going to cut that off. See? Done. That's nice. And if you want to play with a bit of typography again, It's pretty tricky there. Again, change of colors. It's easy to add, just copy text, then play around with the type, fonts. Hello. So since it's a bit of typography they're playing with, probably we'll change the fonts to bold, contents black. Here we go. So yeah, you can see that how Keynote is a gem of a presentation tool. If you want to play around with fonts and create your own custom designs and templates, it's as easy as that. In fact, one of the other key features which I missed out from this is the remote function. Now, since I use Keynote in my iPhone as well, so I'll show you how the remote works. So you just take a presentation, play, voila, here you go. You have your presentation that you can control the presentation from your iPhone using an iPad or vice versa. And there's a lot of presenters tool you can play with. Let's say, for example, you have your laser, or maybe you want to mark something, let's say like this, as easily as done. This is something that's worked for me always. I mean, people have always asked me how you present using your phone or an iPad with remote. So these are one of the key features for Keynote and why this is a must-have tool for every presenter. Let me know what you think about this.